I think birch bark is one of the most amazing materials. And what I want to make now is a storage box to take on a canoe trip. And I'm going to use a European technique, really, to make this. Because wherever the birch tree grows, the people who live alongside it have adapted its bark to their needs. And the quality of the bark varies from country to country and from species to species. But one of the things that's really interesting is the box I'm going to make. When you put foodstuffs in there, the birch bark actually has a preservative effect and it helps to prevent them going off. And it's just a remarkable material. It's so flexible and enduring. It's a lovely thing to work with. And for this, I've cleaned up the outside of the bark, peeled off bits, so I've got a nice smooth outside. And that's going to go inside the basket container. And then I'm going to line it with another piece of bark, also with the inside of the bark, the inner part of the bark, facing outwards. So there'll be a lining inside, so somewhat like that, so that there's no peeling surface to shed into the foodstuffs. The first job, I've got to tidy this up and cut it to the right size. I'm marking out very carefully with this pencil, because not only am I making a functional object, but I want it to be a thing of beauty. An important principle of bushcraft, when we're crafting things, making things that go a little bit beyond just function, take a little bit extra time and care, goes a long way. I'm also going to use some glue when I manufacture this, and that's because I think that birch bark is a precious resource. I can make this basket, this box, without the use of glue, but it won't last as long. If I glue it together, it'll last longer, and with a precious resource like this, that feels better. It doesn't matter how many times you do this, there's still a good chance that you could cut the wrong bit out. It's really frustrating when that happens. I have to follow the old maxim. Measure twice, cut once. So that's all the cutting out done. Now, with any luck, I should be able to fit these together. This is one of those fiddly jobs. What I have to do now is put in a liner and glue it in so that we'll hold it all together nice and neat and tidy. I've taken a very thin piece of bark, a piece I've stripped it down layer by layer till I get this nice flexible piece, and I want the outside in this case to become the inside of the box so that there's no peeling surface to shed into the foodstuffs. What I'm doing now, I'm putting in the wooden form which I've made. These are the wedges. Apply pressure to the interior of the bark box, stretches it out. It's a critical part of the whole process. It's a matter now of waiting for that glue to dry. Let's take the string off. Always a nervous moment. Are they glued in or not? Well, sounds great. There we go. What we have to do now is fit a base and a cap. This is a fairly laborious process, carving these out, so you might want to occupy yourself with something else while I carve these out.